transitioning to Congress's past, I want to show you a picture from the 102nd Congress, and it's very interesting. It is the Gang of Seven. And you'll see there in the second row on the left, John Boehner, now the Speaker of the House, on the front row, just there in front of John Boehner, our next guest, Frank Riggs, former United States Congressman from California, now the president and CEO of the Joe Foss Institute. Frank, we want to talk to you about civic education, but there's a real life civic education going on right now with the new Congress being sworn in. You worked closely with John Boehner when you were freshman in Congress back in 1991. Will Speaker Boehner keep his job? 2 minutes remain in this segment.
Good to be with you, JD, my friend and former colleague. And I want you to know I'm coming to you from the offices of the Joe Foss Institute, right in the heart of your former congressional district, my friend. But to answer your question, back then, John Boehner, I think, was a reformer at heart. I mean, he's clearly now an institutional guy. And I think I will always truly be a reformer. And I don't know how it plays out back there today. You and I have both been there and done that, but I suspect if I had the privilege of serving in Congress today, I don't think I'd be voting to reelect John Boehner Speaker of the House.
Moving along, what do you think Congress, the new Congress, will focus on for this new year? We've been hearing about the XL pipeline, immigration, Obamacare. What issues do you think they'll be focusing on the most?
Oh, good grief. I mean, the XL pipeline is long overdue. Obviously, they need to focus first and foremost on the economy and jobs, but I have a feeling international affairs, and in particular, our national security will also be a very prominent issue. I mean, we're dealing with threats around the globe, certainly the Middle East, the cyber security attack by North Korea. So I hope we can find the proper balance between the focus on domestic affairs and really getting the economy going again, despite the continued resistance and opposition of this president and his administration, but also looking very closely at our national security and whether we have adequate defenses in place against all the threats against our country.
Fair enough. We will have to leave it right there, Frank, but we're going to bring you back following the break. Got to follow up on one statement you made right there, and then the whole topic of civic education. Some Frank talk about education ahead. Stay with us. Frank Riggs joins us, continuing the conversation. Frank, now the CEO and president of the Joe Foss Institute and the Civics Proficiency Initiative. Frank, Miranda Kahn's going to get into civic education in just a second, but you said something very interesting at the outset. You said if you were in Congress today, you would not vote for John Boehner to remain as Speaker.
That's right, JD. Well, and the simple reason is I think the American people, the electorate, spoke loud and clear in November's election and sent a mandate that I think has fallen on deaf ears, frankly, on the part of Speaker Boehner, John, as I know him, as obviously a longtime personal acquaintance. And I think it's a mistake. I think the cromnibus, that whole situation was a mistake. And I think it's a mistake to continue business as usual in Washington, D.C. And that's why I say I think a change in the leadership in the House is absolutely necessary.
But Frank, what's the likelihood of something like this to happen? Because we've talked to other people. We had Javier Manjarres the other day from Shark Tank, and he said it's not going to happen, guys.
That's a very good question, and I think it goes back to the question that JD posed to your prior guest, the member who's just declared his candidacy for Speaker, and that is, I think they're kind of getting a late start. The flip side of that is, I guess, if you declare too early, there could be repercussions within the House Republican Caucus, what JD and I know as the House Republican Conference. So I don't know. I just I'm not there. I don't know the inside baseball anymore. What I do know is way back then, as JD just recited, in the 102nd Congress, we were change agents. In fact, Newt Gingrich, the up-and-coming, at the time, Republican Minority Whip, later obviously the Speaker under which JD and I both served, sent me a note with that article. I believe JD is referring to an article in USA Today that just says, said, Frank, keep up the good work. Remember, change takes courage and effort. And I think that's a message that still applies today. I'd like to believe that because what we did with the Gang of Seven, exposing the House Bank and post office scandals, paved the way for the Republican takeover in 1994. That, like November, was a wave election. In fact, it's a wave election that sent J.D. Hayworth and two other newly elected Republican congressmen from Arizona to the House. And again, I just don't think that Boehner and the leadership in the House are heeding the message that November, in fact, was a wave election.
Now, Frank, we brought you on here. We're glad to talk about what's going to happen today in Washington. And what you were reciting was part of history, not ancient history, but what is the prologue for what's happening today. Civic education. In your new role with the Joe Foss Institute, I understand there are different state legislatures and various state legislatures are moving to pass proficiency quizzes to graduate from high school, being able to pass the same test that our new citizens have to pass. Are you guys behind that? Do you think that's a good idea at the Joe Foss Institute?
We're leading the charge, JD, and it's a great idea. It's a very simple but absolutely vitally important concept. And I think as of yesterday, the latest count, we have like 16 states on board. We hope that our state, our home state, Arizona, be first in the nation to pass a bill that simply requires high school seniors or high school graduates to pass the U.S. citizenship civics test that all new U.S. citizens, all immigrants applying for United States citizenship must pass. And we're trying to get that legislation adopted by working on a bipartisan basis with legislative leaders and obviously governors in all 50 states, with the goal of having that legislation in place by September 2017 to coincide with the 230th anniversary of the signing of the Constitution. So we're very excited about this initiative. It's absolutely in keeping with the vision and enduring legacy of the late Joe Foss, who found, along with his wife Dee Dee, founded the Joe Foss Institute.
And Joe Foss, what a great guy, former governor of South Dakota, World War II aviation ace. Frank Riggs, we'll have you back real soon to talk more about it. And America's Forum is coming right back.